فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. We are on the explanation or in the explanation of the book مختصر في أصول العقائد الدينية written by العلامة عبد الرحمن بن ناصر السعدي رحمه الله تعالى. إن شاء الله تعالى today is going to be our last lesson بإذن الله الكريم. We were speaking about مسألة مرتكب الكبيرة and the groups that have deviated from أهل السنة, what they believe. We mentioned what the Khawarij believe, and the author states what the Khawarij believe, and also what the Mu'tazila believe. So inshallah ta'ala we're going to carry on from there بإذن الله الكريم.
ولا يطلقون عليه الكفر كما تقوله الخوارج أو ينفون عنه الإيمان كما تقوله المعتزلة.
The Sheikh rahimahullah here, as you can see, he speaks about the issue of or the belief of the Khawarij, a deviated group who went against Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, the belief that they have regarding the murtakib al-kabira, the person who does the major sin. So what do the Khawarij do? The Khawarij يطلقون عليه لفظ الكفر. They place the word kufr on the person. So they say that the person is a kafir by doing a major sin. As for the Mu'tazila, as the Sheikh says, ينفون عنه الإيمان. They negate iman from him, but they don't give him the word kufr. So they're both the same on one thing here right now, which is they both negate iman from the person. They both do. لكن the Khawarij choose to place kufr on you after that. Whereas the Mu'tazila, they take you out of iman, but they don't place you into the da'iratul kufr, the realm of disbelief. So what do? They say you are a station between the two stations. The two stations for them here is what? Iman and kufr. You're a station in between, which is manzilatun bayna al-manzilatayn. But what about the Day of Judgment? They say, the Mu'tazila say, Khalid mukhalladan fi an-nar. The person will stay in the hellfire forever. The Khawarij also say that the person will stay in the hellfire forever. And then the khilaf between the two of them is really what? Khilaful lafzi. It's a khilaf of wording. It's a dispute, an argument that's based on wording. But the natija and the thamarah, the outcome and the result are both the same, which is that the person will stay in the hellfire forever. And they also both agree that the negation of iman should be done, that the iman should be negated from the person. They both agree upon that. Na'am. So this is what the Khawarij and the Mu'tazila believe. That's why the Sheikh says, لا يطلقون عليه الكفر. أهل السنة والجماعة don't place kufr on you كما تقول الخوارج, like the Khawarij do. أو ينفون عنه الإيمان, or they don't negate from you إيمان كما تقوله المعتزلة, as the معتزلة say. They don't do that. نعم.
بل يقولون هو مؤمن بإيمانه فاسق بكبيرته فمعه مطلق الإيمان.
So this is أهل السنة والجماعة now. Now we learn what the Khawarij believe. We've also learned what the Mu'tazila believe, which is a deviated group. What is أهل السنة والجماعة believe? The فاعل الكبيرة, the مرتكب الكبيرة, the one who does the major sin. What do they believe? They believe he's مؤمن بإيمانه. He's a مؤمن based on the iman that he has. فاسق, he's a criminal and a transgressor. بكبيرته, based on the major sin that's with him. So the major sin that he has is acknowledged in the sense where it reduces and it affects his iman. But also his iman is not fully stripped from him. عرفتم? His iman is not stripped from him. Now the Sheikh mentions what's with him, what iman is with him. فَمَعَهُ مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ. Now, it's amazing and it shocks me that the people will talk about the belief of the Khawarij, and they'll talk about the belief of the Mu'tazila, they'll speak about the Murji'ah. Some people would label another person, another Ahlul Sunnah brother, they'll say he's a khariji. This brother, he's a khariji, wallah. Simply and easily. And another person will say, Fulan, murji, wallah, he's a murji. Fulan's a murji. And if you ask that individual, do you know mutlaqul iman and imanul mutlaq? What's the difference based on Ahlul Sunnah? What do they, how do they, what's the difference? Al-imanul mutlaq, al-mutlaqul iman. Al-imanul mutlaq, al-mutlaqul iman, what's the difference? What's the difference between wajibul iman and imanul wajib? If you can't distinguish between these terms which Ahlul Sunnah use, how are then you going to say that this is the belief of Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah, or this is the belief of Fulan, or this is the belief of Allan, if you don't even know the terms in which Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah use? Are you with me, brothers? So the Shaykh, here, look what he says. مُؤْمِنُ بِإِيمَانِ فَاسِقُ بِكَبِيرَتِي فَمَعَهُ مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ is with this person who just committed a major sin. What's the مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ? مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ means أَصْلُ الْإِيمَانِ. He still has أَصْلُ الْإِيمَانِ. So when the word مُطْلَق goes before the إيمان, so when you say مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ, what does it mean? It means أَصْلُ الْإِيمَانِ. This person is still a believer. He still has the amount that brings him into Islam. He still come with it. Good. Are you with me? Al-Imanul al-mutlaq, like he means what? Al-Imanul kamil. Because look what the Shaykh says, look what he says. مُؤْمِنٌ بِإِيمَانِ فَاسِقٌ بِكَبِيرَتِي فَمَعَهُ مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ وَأَمَّا الْإِيمَانُ الْمُطْلَقُ فَمَعَهُ مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ وَأَمَّا الْإِيمَانُ الْمُطْلَقِ يُنْفَى عَنْهُ. So he uses the both terms. So مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ means أَصْلُ الْإِيمَانِ. The أَصْل of Iman is with him. He's still a believer. وَأَمَّا الْإِيمَانُ الْمُطْلَقُ. الْإِيمَانُ الْمُطْلَقُ means كَامِلُ الْإِيمَانِ, the complete Iman. The complete Iman, then that is what? It's deficient. His Iman is not complete. It's deficient. يُنْفَى عَنْ, we negate that from you. So we will say to you that you have مُطْلَقُ الْإِيمَانِ, but you don't have الْإِيمَانُ الْمُطْلَقُ if you come with major sins. Right, brothers? That's what Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah use, and that's the term in which they place on the person who comes with a major sin. And as we mentioned last lesson, we said something last lesson. What did we say? We said within Ahlul Sunnah they differ on a mas'ala. And the thing that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah differ upon is, are you there, brothers? Is the person called a Muslim or a mu'min? Are you there? Brothers, pay attention here. So one view of Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, what did they say? He's a Muslim. That's one view within Ahlul Sunnah. The second view is they say, no, is مُؤْمِنٌ بِإِيمَانِهِ فَاسِقٌ بِكَبِيرَتِهِ. And that khilaf is called khilaf lafdi. It's a khilaf lafdi. Why is it a khilaf lafdi? They both believe the مُرْتَكِبِ الْكَبِيرَ is not a person who loses the faith, the belief of Iman. Now, one thing you also need to remember, which is that in the Nusus al-Kitabi wa Sunnah, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min, Wallahi la yu'min, who? The person who لا يأمن جاره بوائقة, that this, your neighbor doesn't find safety from you, مثلا. Or فلا وربك لا يؤمنون حتى يحكموك فيما شجر بينهم ثم لا يجدوا في أنفسهم حرجا مما قضيت ويسلموا تسليما. Oh, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. All these narrations when Iman is negated, لا يزني الزاني حين يزني وهو مؤمن. صح. These evidences which we see where Iman is stripped from the person. لا يؤمن. لا يؤمن is being said. Are you with me, brothers? He doesn't believe. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that la negation of Iman can either fall into, some of the evidences can be aslul Iman, the foundation of Iman goes. The person becomes a disbeliever for it. Or when your Iman is being stripped from you and the text that say you don't believe, are you with me, brothers? It refers to kamaluhu al-wajib. Kamaluhu al-wajib. Never do Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe that the negation of Iman comes and it's meant by kamaluhu al-mustahab. That's the belief of the murji'ah. The murji'ah are the ones who believe that when the negation in the nusus come, they say that it's meant by kamaluhu al-mustahab. Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah believe it's either aslul Iman that's being negated here or kamaluhu al-wajib. Those are the only two it can fall into. Those are the only two that it can fall into. Naam. So Iman al-mutlaq, what did we say? It means kamil al-Iman, the complete Iman. The complete Iman. As for mutlaq al-Iman, asl al-Iman is with him. Now the question is, فما هي الكبيرة شرعا? What's the kabira? What is a kabira? So when we say مرتكب الكبيرة, we have to understand the reality and the real meaning of what kabira means. صح? فحد الكبيرة, the definition and the meaning of kabira is that إن الكبيرة شرعا, it is ما نهى عنه, anything that the Sharia prohibits and says it's impermissible, على وجه التعظيم, in a manner which the Sharia makes it big, magnifies. The kabira is what the Sharia prohibits, على وجه التعظيم, magnifies it, great, makes it great. Because what does Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says, إن تجتنبوا كبائر ما تنهون عنه نكفر عنكم سيئاتكم وندخلكم مدخلا كريما. سورة النساء آية 31. نعم. And how would one know what the Sharia has made, magnified it and made it big? If you go to the Kitab and the Sunnah, you find them over 30 ways. طرق and ways in which you could find out.
وبهذه الأصول يحصل الإيمان بجميع نصوص الكتاب والسنة ويترتب على هذا الأصل أن الإسلام يجب ما قبله وأن التوبة تجب ما قبلها وأن من ارتد ومات على ذلك فقد حبط عمله وَمَنْ تَابَ الله عليه.
So the Sheikh here, rahimahullah, he says, وَبِهَذِي الْأُصُولِ, all those fundamentals and points that have been mentioned, يَحْصُلُ الْإِيمَانِ. Do you want to have iman? Do you want to have faith? With all of those fundamentals and all those points that have been mentioned, it comes with what? When you believe in بِجَمِيعُ نُصُوصِ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُّنَّةِ. When you believe in all the textual evidences that are in the Kitab and the Sunnah. ويترتب على هذا الأصل, one of the things that also is built on this foundation is أن الإسلام يجب ما قبله, that coming into Islam will nullify and it will get rid of everything that you done before it. If you were committing zina before Islam, if you were a fornicator, if you were an adulteress, if you were an idol worshipper, if you were disobedient to your parents, if you murdered somebody, whatever it may be, the Sharia is coming to Islam will get rid of all of the sins that you've done before. وَأَنَّ التَّوْبَةَ تَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَهَا, and the tawbah, repentance, will also get rid of everything which you've done before it. So some people, what they do is this statement, وَأَنَّ التَّوْبَةَ تَجُبُّ مَا قَبْلَهَا, they attribute it to hadith of Amr ibn al-As in Sahih Muslim, and this is what? This is مِنَ الْغَلَبْ, it's from the mistakes that some people fall into. نعم. وَأَنَّ مَنِ ارْتَدَّ, and anyone who apostates, وَمَاتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ, and he dies. So pay attention. A person apostates, does all of his actions nullify straight away? It's a khilaf. Like in القول الراجح, the strongest opinion is that if a person apostates from Islam, his actions are not nullified until he dies. Until he dies. فَقَدْ حَبِطَ عَمَلُهُ, then once you die, then your actions are all nullified. وَمَنْ تَابَ, and anybody who repents, تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ, Allah تبارك وتعالى will accept your repentance. In the sense where, if the person repents and comes back to Islam, are you with me, brothers? For instance, let's say, how many times is Hajj obligatory on a person in their lifetime? Once a lifetime, right? So let's just say a person done Hajj. Somebody done Hajj, and they apostated. And then before they died, they repented. They repented. Do they have to come back with Hajj? Do we say that the Hajj that you did has gone? It's null and void. You have to come back with a Hajj. We'll say, no, all their righteous deeds come back again. Are you with me? And also the fact that they apostated and they left Islam. Are you with me? And they left Islam and they've now repented from it and they came back to Islam. Islam accepts their repentance. وَمَنْ تَابَ تَابَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ. Anyone who repents, Allah تبارك وتعالى accepts their repentance. The repentance is accepted. So if you come with kufr and you come with ma'asiyah, you come with disbelief, or you come with a sin, and then you repent to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, you need to remember whilst you're alive in this world, it's all forgiven. as for kufr, is not forgiven the day of judgment. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, إن الله لا يغفر أن يشرك به ويغفر ما دون ذلك لمن يشاء. But what Allah tabarak wa ta'ala forgives is whilst you're in this world. If you come with kufr of this world and you repent from it, repentance is accepted. It's accepted. Na'am.
ويرتبون أيضا على هذا الأصل.
When the Sheikh says ويرتبون أيضا على هذا الأصل, and they build upon this أصل. What does it mean, this أصل? It means حقيقة الإيمان, the reality and the understanding of إيمان. أهل السنة build something else on it. Are you with me, brothers? When the Sheikh says ويرتبون أيضا, they build on على هذا الأصل, on this foundation, they build something else on it, which is what, which is going to mention. But في حقيقة الإيمان is talking about. So if you really want to be a person who comes with the musamma al-iman, the iman according to Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, come with, the Shaykh says there's something else they add to it as well. And we already spoke about one, which was what? We already spoke about what? Al-imanu qawlun wa amal. The iman is qawlun amal. That was, we said, if you don't come with that, you have not come with what? You haven't come with iman based on the definition of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. That the iman is qawlul qalbi and qawlul lisan, right? عمل القلب على عمل الجوارح. أهل السنة والجماعة, this is what they believe that the iman is. Are you with me? And all of these four, we said they are found in the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, عليه الصحيح مسلم, right? الإيمان بضع وستون شعبة, بضع وسبعون شعبة. We said that 60 is better. بضع وستون شعبة, أعلاها قول لا إله إلا الله وأنها إماطة الأذى عن الطريق والحياة شعبة. We said والحياة شعبة من الإيمان, صح? So we said this hadith compiles all the, combines and it gathers all four types of what we mentioned from qawlul qalb, qawlul lisan, al-amalul qalb, and al-amalul jawarih. Then we said the second thing that the person needs to come with is that yazidu bi-ta'ati wa yanqusu bil-ma'asiyah. That the iman increases with obedience and it decreases with what? Disobedience. That was the second thing that we mentioned. And we mentioned many ayat for it. Wa yazdada al-ladina amanu imana. Allah increased the believers' iman. Also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says in many ayah, وَالَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهِ وَإِذَا ذُكِّرَ اللَّهُ وَجِلَتْ قُلُوبُهُمْ وَإِذَا تُلِيَتْ عَلِيمُ آيَاتُ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ زَادَتْهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَعَلَى رَبِّهِمْ يَتَوَكَّلُونَ. So many evidences. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. So again, verses like that. And also the fact that the iman decreases, we said من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أضعف الإيمان. Also said the hadith in which the Prophet ﷺ, he said ما رأيت ناقصات عقل ودين. صح. Even that, inshallah ta'ala, can this be used as an evidence for the naqs of iman فيه ما فيه, it's not strong enough. But that, inshallah ta'ala, we'll discuss in our explanation in Sahih al-Bukhari, Kitab al-Iman, inshallah ta'ala, more in that. Now the Sheikh is going to go to the next point that we spoke about, which is the issue of al-istithna. The issue of what? Istithna fi al-Iman. Now, which is the third thing, remember. We mentioned that in the beginning, right? We spoke about al-Iman qawlu amal, yazidu bita'a wa yanqusu bil-ma'asiyah, which was those two. And now he's going to talk about the issue of istithna. Now.
ويرتبون أيضا على هذا الأصل صحة الاستثناء في الإيمان.
So here this is مسألة الاستثناء في الإيمان. And that means when a person comes with أنا مؤمن إن شاء الله. I am a believer إن شاء الله. And what we said is based on أهل السنة والجماعة is what? جواز الاستثناء في الإيمان. What is it like? لا باعتبار أصله. It's not based upon the أصل of the إيمان. No, it's not because our istithna, our insha'Allah, is not based upon the asl of the iman. This doesn't mean that. And why do Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah permit, and then why do they allow the person to come, or why is it allowed for a person to come with ana mu'minun insha'Allah? Why? They say, because of many reasons, but from those reasons is the issue of that nobody's iman is complete. Or no one should claim that their iman is complete by saying that I've done all righteous actions and I've left off all prohibited things. That's something hard to claim. That I do fi'lu jami' al-ta'at, all acts of obedience, I've done them. And I've stayed away from all prohibited things. This is hard. So that's the first reason. The second reason is they believe, which is the acceptance is with Allah. Al-qabool عند Allah. Allah is the one who accepts. As Allah says in the Quran, إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. Allah is the one who accepts from the righteous people. So they are ones who know that this action that they've come with, even if they've done all of that which was told for them to do, and they stayed away from all of the things they were told to stay away from, they still believe that whether it got accepted or not, that's in the hands of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. And the third one, which is the last one, which is khawfu, is to be scared, khawfan min tazkiyatin nafs, is to be scared of praising yourself. And that's what they're running away from. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, فَلَا تُزَكُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. Don't praise yourself, because Allah knows the one who is pious from amongst you. So the issue of istithna fi al-iman, we summarized it there inshallah ta'ala. This mas'ala, it has laha judur. There's so many branches that come out of it. Mutafarriqa. There's so many points that come out of it. And we are not trying to now go into that issue and deal with it from all angles. Na'am. So we will leave that point for now there, and that's good understanding that we have regarding it. Na'am.
فَيَصِحُّ أَنْ يَقُولَ أَنَا مُؤْمِنٌ إِنْ شَاءَ اللَّهُ لِأَنَّهُ يَرْجُو مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى تَكْمِيلَ إِيمَانِهِ فَيَسْتَثْنِيَ لِذَلِكَ وَيَرْجُو الثَّبَاتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ إِلَى الْمَمَاتِ فَيَسْتَثْنِي مِنْ غَيْرِ شَكٍّ مِنْهُ بِحُصُولِ أَصْلِ الْإِيمَانِ.
This is, as I mentioned, the issue is not أصل الإيمان. So when he says that the istithna, the inshallah that you're saying, أنا مؤمن inshallah لأنه يرجو من الله تعالى تكميل إيمانه. You're actually hoping from Allah that Allah completes your iman. That's what you hope. وَيَرْجُو الثَّبَاتَ عَلَى ذَلِكَ. And you're hoping that you're firm and steadfast upon it until the day of judgment. فَيَسْتَثْنِي مِنْ غَيْرِ شَكٍّ مِنْهُ. And you're not upon doubt, بحصول أصل الإيمان, that the أصل of the iman is present. So the issue is not the أصل الإيمان, it's the كمال الإيمان that we're referring to when we say أنا مؤمن إن شاء الله, that I am a believer إن شاء الله. نعم.
ويرتبون أيضا على هذا الأصل أن الحب والبغض أصله ومقداره تابع للإيمان وجودا وعدما وتكميلا ونقصا.
The Sheikh rahimahullah, he mentions here right now, ويرتبون أيضا أهل السنة والجماعة also build upon حقيقة الإيمان. The true understanding of iman is another issue, which is the issue which is known as الحب والبغض, loving and hating. And he says here, أن الحب والبغض أصله ومقداره. The أصل, the foundation of disliking and liking somebody, or hating and loving somebody. نعم. And also the amount of love and hate that you're going to have for a person. All of that is تابع للإيمان. It follows the person's iman. Does that make sense? My love to you is based upon your iman. That it follows up your iman. وجوداً وعدماً. The presence of your iman and the absence of your iman. That's what it's based upon. If your iman is present, then okay, how much of it is present? And how much of it is reduced? My love is based upon that. وَتَكْمِيلًا وَنَقْصًا. And how much of it is it complete and how much of it is reduced? Based upon that, a person with what? He will love a person. And based on that, he will hate a person. So you might find two Muslims. One's iman is very high, your love for him is high. There's another believer whose iman is low, your love for him is less. Your love is for him less. Sahih? So the love and the hate is all based upon what? Your love and your hate is all based upon what? It's based upon the person's iman. It's based upon the person, his iman. If the person has iman, your love for him is what? It's present. You can't strip love from him for him if he's got iman. Sahih? But if his iman is extremely low, your love for him is extremely low. If his iman is very high, then your love for him is very high. That's what the qadiyah and the point he's trying to mention here. Rahimahullah ta'ala. Na'am.
ثم يتبع ذلك الولاية والعداوة, ولهذا من الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله, والولاية لله والعداوة لله.
These terms, الحب والبغض والولاء والولاء والبراء, these are terms that are synonyms. Yeah? They are terms which are similar in terms of meaning. So, and the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said in a hadith, إن أوثق عرى الإيمان الحب في الله والبغض في الله. One of the greatest branches of Iman is to love for the sake of Allah and to hate for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a person loves a person based on what? The person's Iman. And he hates the person based on the person's disbelief or the person's sins that are with them. So look at this. The hub, it has kamil and it has naqis. Are you there? Or what we'd say is hub tam and hub naqis. The same is with what? Wala, which is allegiance. The allegiance here can be allegiance, which is what? Huh? The allegiance here is tam, complete. Or it could be naqis, deficient. All of that is based upon the person's iman. بحسب ما يكون من الإيمان في العبد يحب وبحسب ما يكون به من المعصية يبغض. نعم.
ويترتب على الإيمان ولا يتم إلا بأن يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه.
And also, one of the things that are built upon حقيقة الإيمان is what? أن يحب لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. To love for your brother what you love for yourself. This is based upon the hadith of Anas ibn Malik, which you find in Sunan Nasa'i and Sahih ibn Hibban. That a person's Iman is not complete unless you love for your brother what you love for yourself. Now, this love, brothers, and hate, or this hadith, sorry, which says that you're not a true believer until you love for your brother what you love for your. This is talking about umur ad-diniyya, religious matters. Religious matters, it is obligatory. يجب على العبد أن يحب هذه كما يحبها لنفسه. أن يحبها له أبا لأخيه كما يحبها لنفسه. It is the religious matters which is obligatory on you to love for your brothers and your sisters what you love for yourself. Religious matters. If you learn the sunnah, you need to love the sunnah for them. You love to stay away from bid'ah for yourself, you should love it for them as well. You love to be min ahli tawheed, you should love it for them as well. So you're loving for them, the love that you have for them, or the hadith referring to, is the issues that are pertaining to al-umur al-diniyya. Are you with me, brothers? That's what the hadith means. أما الأمور الدنيوية, as for worldly issues and worldly, فإنها تختلف, that differs بحسب ما يكون من أثرها فيه. It all differs on the effects that come out of it. For example, are you with me, brothers? For example, if it becomes غلبة الظن, high assumption you believe that, or you come to understand that there's not going to be any مضلّة, there's not going to be any harm or any problem in this issue, in this worldly issue, لَهُ أَحَبَّهَا لِأَخِيهِ. You love it for your brothers what you love for yourself. As for if you know that it might harm, then it's not, you don't love it for your brothers the way you love it for yourself. Are you with me, brothers? So this hadith is مِنَ الْعَامِ الْمَخْصُوصِ. Some people use it for worldly issues as well, and they unrestrictedly want to use it. The hadith is not like that. The hadith is talking specifically about, and it's connected to what? It's connected to al-umur ad-diniyya, religious matters, not matters which are worldly matters. So the issues of the world, religion, it is what? يجب كله. All of you have to love for your brothers and sisters. As for the world, the dunya, the worldly issues, فَبِحَسَبِ مَا يَكُونُ مِنْ أَثَرِهِ. It's all based on the effects that come out of it. And it all differs from situation to situation. نعم.
وَيَتَرَتَّبُ عَلَى ذَلِكَ أَيْضًا مُحَبَّةُ اجْتِمَاعِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْحَثُ عَلَى والحث على التالف والتحابب وعدم التقاطع.
So here the Sheikh Rahimahullah, he talks about another issue. He mentions that it's based upon the iman. It falls under the issue of iman, which is that mahabbat ijtima'i al-mu'minin, loving that the believers come together. وَالْحَثُّ and to urge them عَلَى التَّآلُفِ, that you urge them to have ulf, love and brotherhood. وَالْتَحَابُّ وَعَدَمُ التَّقَاطُعِ, they have love for one another and they don't cut each other. There's no disconnection and cutting of one another. So Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah, from the, and this, by the way, you have to understand, these are matters that are brought in Aqeed as well. Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah talk about these issues in Kutub al-Aqaid, which is the issue of ijtima' al-mu'mineen, bringing the believers together. Wal-hath ala ta'aluf, and working hard to bring the hearts of the believers together. Wal-ta'abib wa'adamu al-taqatu'i, and that they don't boycott one another. So Ahl al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah yad'una ila mahabbati al-mu'mineen wal-ta'alufi baynahum. Ahl al-Sunnah call the believers to this. They call the Muslims to come together based on the statement of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا وَاذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذْ كُنْتُمْ أَعْدَاءً فَأَلَّفَ بَيْنَ قُلُوبِكُمْ فَأَصْبَحْتُمْ بِنِعْمَتِهِ إِخْوَانًا وَكُنْتُمْ عَلَى شَفَا حُفْرَةٍ مِنَ النَّارِ فَأَنْقَذَكُمْ مِنْهَا. This ayah clearly tells us that وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا. This ayah tells us two things. What are the two things that he tells us? Are you there, brothers? This ayah, what does it tell us? This ayah tells us to come together. But before it tells us to come together, it tells us to do something before that. What is it? وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ. It tells us to hold onto the rope of Allah, then it says together. The rope of Allah comes first and then we do it together. And the way that, the thing that unites us and brings us together is the fact that we hold onto the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's amazing because if you look at the siyaq of the ayah, if you look at the context, look after the ayah that comes after it. What's the ayah that comes after it? Allah says, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا وَاخْتَلَفُوا مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْحَقِّ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ. Allah says, don't be like, وَلَا تَكُونُوا كَالَّذِينَ تَفَرَّقُوا, those who dispersed and divided up. مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَهُمُ, when the truth and the haqq and the knowledge came to them, they divided amongst themselves. When did the division come? When they went against the truth, when they went against the haqq. So that's what causes disunity and breaks the Muslims' lines up, is when they go against Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala's legislation and they go against Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala's religion. Are you with me, brothers? And if you look at the hadith al-iftiraq, the hadith that the Prophet ﷺ told us that the Ummah are going to divide, what did he say? ستفترق أمتي على 73 فرقة كلها في النار إلا واحدة. The Prophet told us that all of the groups and every all of them are going to go to the what? The Ummah going to divide into how many groups? 70? 73 sects. All of them are in the hellfire except what? Except what? One. The companions asked, they said, Ya Rasulullah, who is this one saved one? Who are they? The Messenger عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, من كان على مثل ما أنا عليه اليوم وأصحابي. The one who is upon, the one that is upon, that which I and my companions are upon. الجماعة. In another narration he says. Another narration the Prophet said, السواد الأعظم. صح? What is riwayat? So what does it mean that, or what does it show us, this narration? It shows us that every other group that's going to go to the hellfire, what did they not come with? They are not upon the path of the Prophet ﷺ. And why did they divide? Why did they become the group, the groups that's going to enter the hellfire? Yeah? Brothers. Why did they become the group that's going to enter the hellfire? Why? The reason why they became it is because لِمُخَالَفَتِهِمْ, because they went against طريق النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet's path. And they went against the path of the what? Companions of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it's upon every Muslim to work hard to unite the Muslims in the way that the Sharia wants you to unite them. or to bring the believers together in the way that the Sharia wants you to bring them together. What's the way to bring them together? The way to bring them together is based upon a common ground, bringing them all to the truth. And by default, they will agree. If you look at Imam Intisar al-Haq, Intisar al-Ashab al-Hadith, written by Imam Abu Mudaffar Sam'ani, rahimahullah, is a great book, giving victory to the people of Hadith. He mentions a very powerful statement. He says that if you travel the world, he said, you go to Khurasan, you go to Iraq, you go there, wherever you travel in the world, Ahlul Hadith, Ahlul Sunnah are always the same. They might come in different colors, different ethnicities, different backgrounds, different nationalities. But you need to travel the world, guess what you're going to see? They all speak the same, they all talk the same, they're all in agreement, but they've never met each other. They don't know each other, they don't contact each other in the sense where they don't know each other. Sah? But what is it that united them and brought them together? Their manba is safi, their source which they're taking from is pure and is clean. And wallahi, my beloved brothers and sisters, for people to unite, what is it that can unite people? What can unite them is a divine law, not logic and rationality. That can't unite us. I think different to how you think. And I think different to how he thinks, right? We all think different. And if we try to unite upon rationality and intellect, then we all think differently. We all think differently. And I ask you, my beloved brothers and sisters, billahi alaykum, by Allah, I ask you this question, okay? And I want you to think and ponder whilst when I'm saying this. If rationality can unite us, and intellects can unite us, and emotions can unite us, what was the benefit of sending messengers and prophets? What was the logic and the benefit? If we can come together, rationality and common sense can teach us what's right and wrong, and we can know everything through our rationality, our intellect, then what was the benefit of sending prophets and messengers? The purpose why prophets and messengers were sent was we wouldn't know what Allah wants from us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, what will take us to Jannah. And we also won't be able to unite based on our rationality and our intellect. They're the only ones who can do that for us. Sah? Alayhi salatu wasalam and the companions, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the ghayatu, the ultimate goal in the one who is working towards bringing the believers together and the Muslims together is to bring them together based on the Quran and what's in it. And based upon what? The Sunnah. لذلك الصحابة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Are you with me, brothers? When they differed, and one of them got an issue wrong, are you there, brothers? How were their dealings with it when it came clear to them that what they were upon was wrong? What would they do? They would hasten to what? They would hasten to unity. They would hasten to. So the first Sahabi would find out that what he did, or the ruling that he passed, or his view was wrong. He comes back to the evidence. What would that then result to? They're uniting. Are you there, brothers? And listen to this. And if they differed upon that ruling, and they differed upon it, pay attention, then there was difference of opinion regarding them. That difference of opinion, since it was from the same source, and they were taking it from the right place, and no one was using their bases and their arguments based from rationality and intellect, they were still happy with one another. Like, their differences did not get them to hate one another, to go against one another, to base love and hate. You don't find Ibn Abbas, مثلاً, look at the issue of if your wife breaks your, or if a woman breaks your wudu. Abdullah ibn Abbas's opinion is that she doesn't. Whereas Abdullah ibn Mas'ud's opinion that she does. Do you see a camp that is there a camp, the camp of Ibn Abbas and the camp of Ibn Mas'ud? Are you with me? And you find the wala wal bara of the students of Ibn Abbas and Ibn Mas'ud based on the opinion of their sheikh. Do you see that? Limada, why? Because every single one of them is using ayah from the Quran. Oh, la mistum nisa, I am saying like this. And the other one said, I am saying, oh, la mistum nisa as to be this. So the qadiyah is, lams is what we're disagreeing upon. And what does the context restrict us to mean? لأن السياق من المقيدات. The text is what restricts us. So each and every one of them, is happy with his brother in a discussion. The reason why he's happy with his brother in a discussion is that none of them is using his argument based on rationality, intellect, This is the reality that we need to understand. Naam. So we have to remember that mahabbatul ijtima'i al-mu'minin, to love, to bring the believers together. وَالْحَثُّ عَلَى التَّآلُفِ وَالتَّحَابُبِ وَعَدَمُ التَّقَاطُعِ وَلِذَلِكَ الشَّيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ إِبْنُ الْقَيِّمِ الْجَوْزِيَّةِ. He has a book called فُرُوسِيَةُ الْمُحَمَّدِيَّةِ. And at the end, what does he talk about? He talks about the issue of what? The believers, how could they gain victory? And he brings the ayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا لَقِيتُمْ فِئَةً أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ يا إذا عبد الله قيتم فئة هاي أطيع الله والرسول obey الله and the messenger. Look at this, والله obey الله and his messenger and do not ولا تنازعوا فتفشلوا وتذهب ريحكم واصبروا إن الله مع الصابرين. So the first command is what? Obey Allah and His Messenger. That's what comes first. وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ. Happens because we didn't obey Allah and His Messenger. صح? We didn't. Look at this. بِاللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. When the Prophet صلوات الله وسلام عليه said to the companions the day when he sent them, Khaybar. When the Prophet sent the companions and he said, أَلَا لَا يُصَلِّيَنَّ أَحَدُكُمْ إِلَّا فِي بَنُو قُرَيْضَ. That one of you should not go and pray except in what? In بَنُو قُرَيْضَ. The two groups of the companions, what did they break into? Pay attention here. Ponder here. The companions broke into two groups, two camps. Are you with me, brothers? What did he say? لا يصلين أحدكم. The Prophet said, none of you should pray except in Banu Qurayza. One group of the companions, what did they do? Are you there, brothers? So what happened was, whilst they were going there, the Salah came. Are you with me, brothers? What happened? The Salah came. What happened? The Salah entered before they reached Banu Qurayza. So one group said, the Salah entered, we have to pray. Another group said, did the Prophet not instruct us not to pray except in Banu Qurayza? Are you there? The other ones, they said, listen, when the Prophet had told us to pray in Banu Qurayza, he meant hurry, hasten. Get there fast. But it wasn't literally don't pray except in Banu Qurayza. The other group said no, then take the Prophet's speech. The khilaf here is what? One is taking to the wording and one is taking the meaning. Sahih? And this is the khilaf, as I said to you, the khilafat between the fuqaha is the issue of tawassu' fil lafdi aw al ma'na. Very important. But what did they all agree upon? They're all applying, implementing, following the kalam of the Prophet. Not one of them is disregarding the Prophet's speech. So when they both came back to the Prophet, since they done ijtihad and they strived based on the Prophet's speech والسلام, and what the Prophet said, none of them were rebuked. And none of them were told off. None of them were told off. And none of them were said that you're wrong. And the other was right. And the other was right or you're wrong. And every one of them tried hard based on what the Prophet ﷺ said. Are you there, brothers? And since that is an issue that we need to keep in mind, as for a person who's coming and he's saying to you, I don't take khabar al-ahad method, I don't take singular narrations. Are you there, brothers? And he differs with you. The khilaf la yu'tabar. We're not going to consider your khilaf to be anything. Sah? Are you with me, brothers? Are you there? Or a person is saying to you, you're saying to him, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما قال الله تعالى, Allah said, and the messenger said, you're telling him it, and he's saying to you, my sheikh said, that's not what the evidence is talking about, and that's a misunderstanding of the evidence. عرفتم? So it's important, and أهل السنة والجماعة work hard to making sure that they bring the people together, advise the people, love for the ummah to become one. Because if the ummah become divided, فَتَفْشَلُوا وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, our quwwah, our strength and our power goes. This unity and not being together, and not coming together, it's what causes weakness. And that's what the enemies of Islam want and that they benefit from. Yeah.
ويبرأ أهل السنة والجماعة من التعصبات والتفرق والتباغض ويرون هذه القاعدة من أهم قواعد الإيمان.
So here, أهل السنة والجماعة, they free themselves and they far away from من التعصبات, fanaticism, right? والتفرق والتباغض. And division and hate. ويرون أن هذه, and they see that this قاعدة is من أهم قواعد الإيمان, that is from the greatest principles of الإيمان. السنة والجماعة, they believe it's from the fundamentals of their belief. الألفة المؤمنين ومحبتهم, loving the believers, showing kindness and generosity to the believers, having love and mercy between one another. This is the characteristic Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah mentions. What did he say about Ahlul Sunnah? يعرفون الحق. They know the truth. And they also are what? يعرفون الحق. They know the truth. ويرحمون الخلق. And they're merciful to the creation. So this is the characteristics of this. They know the haq which would bring them closer to Allah. They know it. Are you there? And they also know the batil and the misconceptions that the others are upon, they know it. But مع ذلك يرحمون الخلق. They're very merciful to the creation. It's sad that when you do learn, and you do become a person of knowledge and a person of understanding, that you use that as a means to belittle others and to put them down, so you can get a makana and a position. That's not the case. Knowledge, what should increase in you is mercy towards the creation. The amatul nas, who don't know, who want to know. The person who's confused, was actually confused in an issue. لذلك المعاني, the hard-headed person, هذا شيء آخر. That's another issue. Allah says in the Quran, أدعو إلى سبيل ربك بالحكمة والموعظة الحسنة وجادلهم بالتي هي أحسن. The one who's معاني, hard-headed, وجادلهم. He's not موعظة حسنة. As for the موعظة الحسنة, the one which you speak to, kindly, are the one who is, who's not stubborn, who's not mu'anid, who's not hard-headed. ولذلك, the sad thing is that a person you've never spoken to, you've never advised, you've never met in your entire life, you don't know what this person believes. You're running around boycotting them, and he doesn't even know why you're boycotting them. Nah, this shows that you haven't understood the qawa'id that the Shaykh is mentioning. Sahih? The qawa'id, a person you've not advised, a person you've not spoken to, a person you've not told them what's right from what's wrong, you've not brought the matter clear to them. And even if you did bring the matter clear to them, the reality is that they would have accepted the truth is because of the way you told them and the way you did it. That's why the person doesn't want to take it. It's because of you, they don't want to take it. And the way you portrayed the issue. Na'am. So this has to be something that's a characteristic of yours, my brothers and sisters. يعرفون الحق, learn the truth and become one who knows the truth. Also, be merciful to the creation. Very kind and merciful to the creation. Be very merciful. And be one who's far from ta'asub. Ta'asub here means your sheikh. My sheikh said this, khalas. Ta'asub, like that. Stay away from it. والتفرق, dividing the ummah. Stay away from it. والتباغض, hate. نعم. And the Shaykh has a risala on this particular issue. He has a book he's written on it. Na'am.
وَلَا يَرَوْنَ الْإِخْتِلَافَ فِي الْمَسَائِلِ الَّتِي لَا تُوصِلُ إِلَى كُفْرٍ أَوْ بِدْعَةٍ مُوجِبَةً لِلْتَفَرُّقِ.
The Shaykh here goes into an issue now. الأهل السنة والجماعة, they don't, لا يرون الاختلاف. They don't see disputing and arguing in matters that don't reach kufr bid'ah. Oh, if it reaches kufr bid'ah, it's different now. It's khilaf, dispute, argument, and it's furqa, khilaf that's going to come from us. Not only that, there's going to be hajar and boycotting based on the masalih and of course the mafasid that comes out from it. So the Shaykh rahimahullah here is telling you, before you thought ulfa and loving, and he said you were thinking coming together and loving one another, the Shaykh says, oh, it's not unrestricted. It's not mutlaq, it's not unrestricted. It's restricted to what? It's restricted to if it reaches ila kufrin. If the person becomes a kafir, leaves Islam, there's شيء آخر. Or bid'ah, or he comes with innovation. This now mujibatu للتفرق. This necessitates disunity. It necessitates division. And as you know, the khilaf, not all of them, as you know, my beloved brothers and sisters, every difference of opinion is not acceptable. And it's not considered. وَلَيْسَ كُلُّ خِلَافٍ جَاءَ. Not every single khilaf that comes. وَلَيْسَ كُلُّ خِلَافٍ جَاءَ مُعْتَبَرًا. Not every khilaf that comes is considered. Except إِلَّا مَا كَانَ لَهُ حَظٌ مِنَ النَّظَرِ. Except the one that has, it deserves, and it has a poor, the difference of opinion here is considerable. صحيح. As for every single difference of opinion, لا, it's not مُعْتَبَر. The khilaf that reaches bid'ah is not مُعْتَبَر. It's not considerable. It's not considered. And we won't accept that as a difference of opinion that we'll take from you. And if the khilaf reaches kufr, a person states his beliefs are kufr, and he says, oh, this is difference of opinion, why are you... لا. ولذلك, one of the jahalat, the ignorance that you see nowadays is that, it's one of the sad things, is that a person comes with khilaf, fil usul, usul of the religion, and then when he wants, when you grab him and you say, أخي تقي الله, أخي تقي الله, this is haram, غير جاء, this is bid'ah, or this is مثلا كفر, stay away from this, dangerous. He'll say to you, and he'll respond to you, أخي تقي الله, you guys are restricting khilaf. You, and then he brings you examples of, you know, Imam Malik and Imam Shafi'i differed, and Imam Ahmed differed with Shafi'i, and Fulan differed, this Imam differed with this Imam. We'll say to them, these are masail which are sa'ir. They are they are mu'tabar, considered. As a khilaf that is within the realm of acceptance. But the khilaf that you're coming with is a khilaf which is incorrect. It can't be accepted, this khilaf. This difference of opinion cannot be accepted. And some people, they think to themselves, when you say matters of usul, they think the only khilaf that's not allowed is matters which are aqaid. Some people think that. And even those are good. We now have even people who believe that even aqaid is a different one. What's the problem? Like we're talking about the ones who say that the only khilaf is in issues of aqidah. Sahih? Who said that? The masail fiqh, masail which are fiqh here, that a person can become mubtada' based on it. So what the right way of saying it is that masail which are usul and masail which are furu'. لأنه they are matters of aqidah which are furu'. They're not even usul. There are masail which are aqidah that are furu'. They're not asal. And there are matters which are fiqhiyat that fall under usul. And some fall into furu'. Now the matters of aqidah, majority of them, the overwhelming majority of it, goes into the usul. And of course, the overwhelming majority of the issues of fiqhiyat fall into furu'. Sahih? Sah? But to think to yourself that the issues of fiqh are always furu' and that you can't have difference of opinion in it is incorrect. Are you there? Now, and to always think that every issue of aqeedah, the person becomes a mubtada' based on it, is also another issue which is incorrect. Like an example for this is that Shaykh al-Islam Taymi uses example is the issue of mufadalati bayna Ali wa Uthman. Who do you think is more virtuous? Ali or Uthman? Is it a matter of aqidah? It's an aqidah related matter. Are you with me? بين أهل السنة والجماعة there's a khilaf qadeem. There's a difference of opinion regarding them. بين أهل السنة. This is not مسألة between أهل السنة and البدع. This is a matter of aqidah. Like are you there? ولا يضلل المخالف. The opponent who goes against you في هذه المسألة you can't even do تضليل on him. You can't say he's a ضال ومضل. Misguided person. If he says, for example, Ali is better than Uthman. If he says that Ali is better than Uthman, he's not a misguided person. The maximum that this issue can hold is what? Rajih al-Marjuh. This is stronger than this opinion. Sahih? Because this is a mas'ala khilafiyyah. The khilafiyyah is mu'tabar, it's considered. Are you there, brothers? But, man i'taqad, anyone who believes أن علي أفضل من عثمان. Sorry, anyone who believes أن خلافة علي أولى وأصح من خلافة عثمان فهذا يضلل. As for the one who believes that the Khilafah of Ali was more befitting and it was right. He should have been the Khalifa, and Uthman wasn't. And Uthman shouldn't have been the Khalifa. Anyone who would believe that, then this person is a Dalun Mudil, is misguided. He's Dalun Mudil. Are you there? So here we see issues which are aqidah related. Ba'adalika la yudallal sahibu. A person doesn't become a dal because of it. Because this is mas'ala farah. Part of it is asal and part of it is asfara. The part which is asal is khilafatu Ali and khilafatu Uthman. If you start speaking about that, then you become a mubtadi', a misguided person. But if you talk about al mufadalati bayna Ali wa Uthman, this mas'ala khilafiyya qa'imah bayna a'immati salaf. Bayna salaf. Between the salaf themselves, there was a khilaf regarding them. This. Do you see the point?
No.
So the usul that Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah spoke about in their books of aqa'id, when you read that, those matters are usul. Ajma'u alayha, there is ijma'at on this. Are you there, brothers? And there are five which are ru'us of the masail. Five are ru'us. Mas'alatul iman, mas'alatul sahaba, al-wa'd wal-wa'id, ya, al-qada' wal-qadar, sah? And the issue, the last one, which is what? So I said, mas'alatul sahaba, al-asma' wal-sifat, five. So mas'alatul asma' wal-sifat, mas'alatul al-qada' wal-qadar, mas'alatul asma' wal-ahkam, mas'alatul sahaba, and the issue of wa'd wal-wa'id. Those five are ru'usul masail. They are the five matters which a person has to stick to Ahlul Sunnah regarding. وَيَتَفَرَّعُ مِنْهَا مَسَائِلْ كَمَاتْ from these each one. Lots of issues come out from it. In books of aqa'id, these are the issues that they deal with. Are you with me, brothers? And these five and others have mentioned it. If you Abu Bakr al-Isma'ili, Imam al-Sabuni, and others, they mention it. So what we need to realize is what? The khilaf are mutafawita. The khilaf are different levels. There's khilaf which are accepted, khilaf which are heretic. The person becomes a zindiq, kafir. Sahih? Because a kafir. Now, for example, somebody comes and says, well, the Qadianis right now are Muslims. Because they differ with us on this issue, it doesn't mean it. Their khilaf is mu'tabar. They came to the ayah, وَمَا كَانَ مُحَمَّدُ الْأَبَىٰ أَحَدٍ مِنْ رِجَالِكُمْ وَلَكَ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ وَخَاتَمَ النَّبِيِّينَ. They said, khatam here is my brother's, is a ring. So it means that the ring is a beauty for the finger. So the Prophet ﷺ is just a beauty for all prophets before him. He's beautifying them. He was the beauty of all of them. I mean, in other words, he's the most virtuous of them all. But Ahmed Ghulam Mirza Khan, Mirza, is what? Is a prophet from Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And you guys don't have evidence. And this is what the ayah meant. And then now can you say his khilaf is mu'tabar? He answered the ayah. He goes, zindaqa, zindaqa, kufr. Zindaqa. You don't accept that from anyone, right? Then the khilafat are not of one level. And not every khilaf is a furu'. Khilaf which are usul. And within the usul, some of them are bid'ah and you're mubtada', you're still a Muslim. And some of them you're kufr, kafir, you leave the religion based on it. Now.
ويترتب على الإيمان محبة أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم بحسب مراتبهم وأن لهم من الفضل والسوابق والمناقب ما فضلوا فيه ما فضلوا فيه سائر الأمة.
This the Sheikh رحمه الله is talking about the issue of محبة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم محبة أصحاب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم loving the companions of the messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم بحسب مراتبهم. You love them based on their levels. The companions are loved based on their levels. وعملهم and their actions. وأن لهم من الفضل والسوابق والمناقب ما فضلوا به عن سائر الأمة. And their virtues is based upon their actions and their levels. For example, Umar and Abu Bakr, who's better? Abu Bakr is better. Ali and Uthman, who's better? Uthman's better. And then Ali comes after. And then this is what? The virtue. Abu Bakr comes, and then Umar, and then Uthman, and then Ali. And then who comes after that? Ashar al-Mashareen bil Jannah, the six remaining come after that. And then who comes after that? Ahlul Badr, مثلا, yeah? And then who comes after that? Na'am. And then who comes after that? And the Muhajirin. And then who comes after that? The Ansar. And hakada, the Sah, or the ones who've done Hijrah before, the ones who've done after Hijrah. All of these are the levels of the Maratib. Sahih. Walidhalika, these issues, Imma, they wrote books on it. And they placed it in the Kutub al-Sunnah. For example, the issue of Manaqib al-Sahaba, the virtues of the companions, and Imam al-Bukhari, rahmahullah, and Sahih. The reason is because there were people who tried to slander Adalat al-Sahaba, the companions' integrity and their levels. Naam. So we have to love the companions of the Messenger, salawatullahi wa salamu alayhi.
ويدينون بمحبتهم ونشر فضائلهم ويمسكون عما شجر بينهم.
ويدينون means they make their religion based upon what? بمحبتهم. Our religion is based on their love. We love them. رضي الله تعالى عنهم. We say about them when we. And that's why we said in the ayah, Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says, محمد رسول الله والذين معه أشداء على الكفار رحماء بينهم تراهم ركعا سجدا يبتغون فضلا من الله ورضوانا. سيماهم في وجوههم من أثر السجود ذلك مثلهم في التوراة ومثلهم في الإنجيل كزرع أخرج شطأه فآزره فاستغلظ فاستوى على سوقه يعجب الزراع ليغيظ بهم الكفار. The companions were made so they disbelieved them. And then the person who hates the companions are كفار. Because Allah says ليغيظ بهم الكفار. The companions were placed next to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم so that disbelievers can have hate towards them. صحيح؟ How they aided the Prophet and how they helped him and how they supported him عليه الصلاة والسلام. ولذلك عبد الله بن مسعود he said in an athar which is موقوف ولا يصح مرفوعا, it's not authentic مرفوعا, which is that إن الله نظر إلى قلوب عباده, Allah looked at the hearts of his creation, فرأى, he saw that Muhammad's heart was the best of hearts, so he chose him as a prophet. Then Allah looked at the remaining creation's hearts, and who did he choose? فاختار أصحاب محمد. He chose the companions of the Prophet and he placed them as the Prophet's companions. So the reason why they were placed around the Prophet is because of their heart. In another statement of his, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, what did he say? He said, من كان مستنا فليستنى بمن قدمات فإن الحي لا تؤمن عليه الفتنة أولئك أصحاب محمد أبر هذه الأمة قلوبا وأعمقها علما وأقلها تكلفا اختارهم الله تبارك وتعالى لصحبة نبيهم. So Abdullah ibn Mas'ud clearly mentions here that Allah chose these individuals لِسُحْبَةِ نَبِيِّهِمْ. But why? أَبَرَّ هَذِي الْأُمَّةِ قُلُوبًا. Their hearts were the most obedient of heart. Their hearts obedient. وَعَمَقُهَا عِلْمًا. Their knowledge is the most vast and the most in-depth understanding of the religion. That's the type of people they were. وَلِذَلِكَ حُبُّ الصَّحَابَةِ is إِيمَان وَبُغْضُهُمْ is نِفَاقَ زَنْدَقَ. It's hypocrisy and it's disbelief. And loving them is belief. Also the Sheikh says, so we spread the good about them. Whenever we talk about them, we mention their good and their virtues and things that the people can look up to and glorify the companions with. وَنَشْرِ فَضَائِلِمْ وَيُمْسِكُونَ عَمَّا شَجَرَ بَيْنَمْ. And we also withhold the things that happen between them in the khilafat. The difference of between them, we hold back from them. Are you with me? وَلِذَاكَ السَّلَفْ, they used to say the way Allah saved your soul that day, which you wasn't there. Save your tongue from the situation. Don't talk about it. Now.
وَأَنَّهُمْ أَوْلَى الْأُمَّةِ بِكُلِّ خَصْلَةٍ حَمِيدَةٍ وَأَسْبَقُهُمْ إِلَى كُلِّ خَيْرٍ وَأَبَعَدُهُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ شَرٍ وَيَعْتَقِي.
So the Sheikh says, وَأَنَّهُمْ أَوْلَى الْأُمَّةِ بِكُلِّ خَصْلَةٍ حَمِيدَةٍ. Any good that you see in us, in this ummah, that any great virtues and any good characteristics that are present in this ummah, they are what? They are the most befitting for its first. They're the rightful ones. Are you there? Ayat, when you read in the Quran, for example, that Allah talks about the believers and He praises them. For example, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, who is here? He said the Sahabas. Ibn Abbas said, وَكَذَلِكَ جَعَلْنَاكُمْ أُمَّةً وَسَطًا. He said, أُمَّةً وَسَطًا means the Sahabas. Ibtidan. For example, who else is it? Are you there, brothers? It's referring to nobody other than them. Sahih? When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says in the Quran, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى لَا وَمَا يُشَاكَ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Is the mu'minin the companions only? No, it's not only the companions. It means all the believers till the day of judgment. But who is it first? Who is it? أنهم أولى. They're the most befitting for this fast. No one else takes these characteristics from them, first of all. Any good virtues that are mentioned in the Quran or in the Sunnah, they are the first ones to get it. The first ones to get it. And remember when Imam Ibn Asakir, rahimahullah, what did he say? He said, لحوم العلماء مسمومة وعادة الله في هاتك أستاري منتقصيه معلومة فمن أطلق لسانه بالعلماء بثلب أبلاه الله قبل موت بموت القلب. That the flesh of the scholars is what? Poisonous. And the norms of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is that the person who opens his tongues on the ulama and the people of knowledge, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will destroy his heart and Allah will kill his heart before the true death comes to him. His heart will die. So if a person speaks about an alim min ulama is sunnah, this is what happens to him, right? What do you think about the person who speaks about the companions and who opens his tongue to the companions? So this qawl of Ibn Asakir is kitab Tabiyun al-Kadhib al-Muftari. It's very strong. Very strong, which is that the Sahabas are awla al-ummati bidalik. They're the first ones that we need to protect our tongues from speaking against them and saying anything bad against them. Even when we speak about the companions, we should have good manners and good etiquettes and good sahih. Are you with me, brothers? And when you do say something about the companions of the Messenger, always watch your mouth. Think twice before you say anything. Even if you're talking about their story and you're conveying a story of theirs, don't even say it in a derogative manner, a manner where you're belittling it. Don't even joke about them. Don't belittle the companions in any way, form or shape. When you speak about them, تَرَضِّ عَنْهُمْ say رَضِيَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى عَنْهُمْ and respect them highly. Now.
ويعتقدون أن الأمة لا تستغني عن إمام يقيم لها دينها ودنياها.
They also believe, أهل السنة والجماعة believe أن الأمة, that the أمة لا تستغني, they cannot be without an imam, a leader, a Muslim leader. يقيم لها دينها ودنياها. This issue is known as the what? It's the issue of خلافة and imam, right? The issue of imam, right? But Imam al-Rafid al-Shia, I'm not talking about that one. I'm talking about Imam, the Imam of the Muslims, leaders, a Muslim Hakim. We believe as Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we need it. And it's an issue which is Fardu Kifaya, right? It's Fardu Kifaya. And Imam al-Qurtubi mentions in Qawlu Ta'ala, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلُ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةِ قَالُوا أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَسْفِكُ الدِّمَاءَ وَنَحْنُ نُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِكَ وَنُقَدِّسُ لَكَ قَالَ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. And this issue of Sahaba and the issue of Imamah and the issue of Iman, are you with me, brothers? Is ma yulhaqu, is one of the things that are connected to when spoken about after the six articles of faith, right? Al-Imanu billahi wa malaikati wa kutubi wa rusuli wa liyawmil akhir wa tu'minu bil qadri khayr wa sharri. And the Sunnah, when they speak about all of that, they always speak about the mas'alatul Iman after it, and then they speak about the mas'alatu as-sahaba, and then after they talk about the issue of al-imama, which is wala yarawna al-khuruja. They ahl sunnah wal jama'ah don't see the permissibility of going against a leader, and you know, if he's a sinner and a person who commits sins. So we're going to speak about that, inshallah. Naam.
ويدفع عنها عادية المعتدين ولا تتم إمامته إلا بطاعته في غير معصية الله تعالى.
So أهل السنة والجماعة, they see this is an أصلاً دينياً. This is an أصل, a foundation of their religion, which is the قضية, the issue relating to a imam and a leader of the Muslims. Is that what? You deflect from him the people who are showing him adawa and enmity and hate. You repel him from it. And his imamah, وَلَا تَتِمُّ إِمَامَتُهُ, and his imamah is not complete إِلَّا بِالطَّاعَةِ فِي غَيْرِ مَعْصِيَةِ اللَّهِ, obedience that's given to him. And that when he's obeyed in accordance to the obedience of Allah. If he tells the people to obey them in something that goes against Allah, then he has no rights to be given that. He has no rights to be obeyed in that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is, that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry and is not and does not like. So you لا طاعة لمخلوق في معصية الخالق. That you do not obey the creation in something that angers the creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. نعم.
ويرون أنه لا يتم الإيمان إلا بالأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر باليد وإلا باللسان وإلا بالقلب على حسب مراتبه الشرعية وطرقه المرعية.
The Sheikh رحمه الله, he now talks about the issue of that the iman of a person is not complete unless he does what is known as al-amru bil-ma'roof wa nahi 'anil munkar, calling to the good and prohibiting the evil. And the way that it's done is al-nahi 'anil munkar, prohibiting the evil, is bil yadi, with the hand, wa bil lisani, if you can't do it with your hand then you do it with your tongue, wa illa fa bil qalbi, or else you do it with your heart. And all of this is based upon what? Ala hasabi maratibihi shar'iyyah, based upon the legislational staging and the legislational observation of this issue. وَطُرُقِهِ الْمَرْعِيَّةِ, meaning, what does he mean by وَطُرُقِهِ الْمَرْعِيَّةِ, أي بِحَسَبِ مَا يَسْتَطِعُهُ الْإِنسَانِ. It's all based upon if the person is able to. This issue of your mouth, so your hand, and then doing it with your tongue, and then doing it with your heart, it's all based upon what? It's all based upon your ability, your istita'a. And it's also based upon, the Shaykh mentions, على حسب مراتبه الشرعية. بمعنى مراتبه الشرعية, also the issue of مصالح المفاسد وما يترتب عليها. What's it gonna come? What's gonna come out of it? If you call into the good, are you with me, brothers? Is يترتب عليها ما هو أعظم, greater is going to come out from it, then you have to observe that, and that has to be dealt with as well. That has to be looked into. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية also does the same. Just like Al-Imam Abdul Rahman Nasir Sa'di did right now in this book of his, مختصر في أصول العقائد الدينية, شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية did the same in his عقيدة الواسطية. At the ending, what did he say? وهم, he's talking about أهل السنة, مع هذه الأصول يرون الأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر على ما توجبه الشريعة. He says that وهم, they أهل السنة والجماعة, with all of the foundation that were mentioned, Shaykh Hussam Taymi is saying this. يرون, they see, أن الأمر بالمعروف, calling to the good, والنهي عن المنكر, and prohibiting from the evil, is obligatory على ما توجب الشريعة. نعم. As the Sharia has made it obligatory. And it is. Are you with me? Are you with me, brothers? Allah تبارك وتعالى, what did he say? لعن الذين كفروا من بني إسرائيل على لسان داود وعيسى بن مريم ذلك بما عصوا وكانوا يعتدون كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوا. They were cursed, right? On whose tongue were they cursed? They were cursed on the tongue of نبي الله داود وعيسى بن مريم. Why were they cursed, بني إسرائيل? The reason why they were cursed is because كانوا لا يتناهون عن منكر فعلوا. If one of them done evil, they will not prevent one another from it. They would watch them. This is one thing that this ummah have been given khayriya, virtue over the other nations. This is the, with this we become more virtuous than previous nations. صح? Allah says, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. But when are we going to be it? Is this khayriya, is it khayriya which is irqiya? Pay attention. Is it in our bloods that we're khayr? Is it that or is it something that we've done and we can gain it through? لا, is اكتسابية, we have to gain it. What is it? كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You call to the good, you prohibit the evil, and you believe in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Also Allah says, ولتكن منكم أمة يدعون إلى الخير ويأمرون بالمعروف وينهون عن المنكر. And this statement of the Shaykh here, which is أنه لا يتم الإيمان إلا بالأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر باليد. Are you there, brothers? Are you there? Is the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, من رأى منكم منكرا فليغيره بيده فإن لم يستطع فبلسانه فإن لم يستطع فبقلبه وذلك أضعف الإيمان. Here I want you to ponder here. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Man ra'a minkum munkaran." Why didn't the Prophet say, "Man ra'a minkum sharran"? Why was munkar used? Sahih? The word munkar is more vast than the word shar. I want you to look it up, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to ask you guys this question tomorrow. What's the difference between munkar and the word shar? Why was it used? Also, the hadith says there's another thing, which is man. And man in the adawati, here it shows generalization. In adawati al-umum, anyone, it could be whoever he wants. So to say that only the scholars can do al-amr bi-ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar is jahl. If you're eating with a person and they eat with their left, are you there, brothers? Is man ra'a minkum munkaran falyughayyirhu biyadihi. Now, you stop them. Falls under this hadith. Now.
وبالجملة الجملة فيرون القيام بكل الأصول الشرعية على الوجه على الوجه الشرعي من تمام الإيمان والدين.
نعم. So the Sheikh رحمه الله, he concludes by saying, وبالجملة فيرون القيام, they see to standing up بكل الأصول الشرعية على الوجه الشرعي. They believe all the fundamental matters of the religion coming with them in accordance to how? على الوجه الشرعي, in the legislated manner. Not how they want to and how they perceive it and how they want to. They do it as how they are demanded from Allah and how they are told to come with it. That's the way they come with it. من تمام الإيمان والدين, with complete belief on religion. Complete تمام الإيمان والدين. There's an issue I need to just slightly mention, of the issue of أمر بمعروف, and inshallah ta'ala we will conclude there بإذن الله الكريم, as we've gone on too long. So بإذن الله الكريم, we'll have to finish the next part tomorrow بإذن الله الكريم. But there's an issue I need to mention, which is some people use the issue of al-amru bil-ma'ruf wa-nahy 'anil munkar, and they'll say that you can go against a Muslim leader based on the concept of what al-amru bil-ma'ruf wa-nahy 'anil munkar. ولذلك, at the time of Sa'id ibn al-As, a group of people came out. وَقَدْ خَرَجَ النَّاسُ فِي الْكُوفَةِ عَلَى سَعِيدِ بْنُ الْعَاصِ. They came out on Sa'id ibn al-As. A group of people came out on him, okay, in Kufa. Then Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman came and he scolded them for this act. And then a man said to Hudhayfa, "Ma taqulu fil amri bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar?" What do you say about calling to the good and prohibiting the evil? فقال, Hudhayfa responded by saying, "Inna al-amra bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar la hasan." Calling to the good and prohibiting the evil is something good, something very good. ولكن ليس من السنة, but is not from the sunnah, أن تشهر السلاح في وجه إمامك, that you shither your sword in the face of your leader. Ibn Abi Shayba narrated it, and other than him, authentically. So some people have understood al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar to go against a Muslim leader, to speak against him, to slander him, to talk about him in the media, and they think this is what al-amr bil ma'ruf wa nahy 'anil munkar. And this goes against, as you can all see, it goes against the act of the Sahabas and the Tabi'in. So we should be people who follow the textual evidences and not people who are emotional, who are affected by emotions. So we'll conclude there, inshallah ta'ala, for today's class. Anything which I have said that was wrong, فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي وَمِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ وَاللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ بَرِئَانِ مِنْ. It's from me, as shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll carry on tomorrow from the fiqh asl, inshallah ta'ala. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.